Volusia County, Florida. An Orange City police officer was arrested on a warrant after Georgia authorities said he attempted to extort nude photos from a woman on social media, threatening to kill and rape her family if she did not comply. Joshua David Fancher, 25, was arrested Tuesday at his home in DeLand on a warrant charging him with making terroristic threats, according to officials with the Volusia County Sheriff's Office. Detectives in Lowndes County, Georgia, said Fancher first started messaging the victim on Instagram, demanding she send him nude photos. Fancher threatened to kill the victim and her family and rape them if she didn't send him the photos, according to Lowndes County authorities. Volusia County Sheriff's Office detectives searched Fancher's apartment on a warrant out of Georgia to assist with the ongoing investigation. Fancher was called in from patrol Tuesday morning and arrested. Orange City Police Department spokesperson Lieutenant Jason Samsel said. Fancher resigned from his position with the Orange City Police Department immediately. City Council of Orange City meeting notes show Fancher was hired with the department in October of 2017. Photos posted to the Orange City Police Department Facebook page show Fancher at his swearing-in ceremony in December. The Orange City Police Department will also conduct its own investigation into Fancher. Fancher was booked into the Volusia County Branch Jail and is held without bail. In Miami, during the Memorial Day weekend, motorcycles, ATVs, and police are a common sight, but a disturbing video from the dash cam of a Miami Beach police officer has surfaced. While following a group of dirt bikes and ATVs across the Julia Tuttle Causeway, a Miami Beach police officer is heard yelling. In response, MBPD spokesman Ernesto Rodriguez said that an internal affairs investigation will be launched to investigate what may have been said. Typically, police are barred from pursuing riders on motorcycles, dirt bikes, or ATVs because a high-speed chase could easily kill them. In this instance, Rodriguez said the armada of cops riding behind the bikers was not chasing them. Instead, the department considers the incident a low-speed escort. In California, three men were recently arrested for various offenses, including possessing heroin and methamphetamine, after authorities said they monitored white supremacist gang members in Costa Mesa. One of two traffic stops on Friday resulted in the seizure of $12,000, an undisclosed amount of heroin, a quarter pound of meth, a taser, two batons, and a digital money counter. Earlier in the day, authorities seized meth, a loaded semi-automatic handgun, ammunition, and drug paraphernalia. Brian J. Bishop, 35, of Trinidad, Texas, was arrested on suspicion of meth for sale, possession of a concealed and loaded firearm while possessing drugs and possessing a firearm but not being the registered owner, authorities said. Since the arrest, Bishop posted bail and was released. Norman Michael Powers, 53, of Midway City, was arrested on suspicion of possessing heroin and meth for sale, having a taser and billy clubs and resisting an officer, authorities said on Tuesday. Powers is in custody on a $250,000 bill. David Lynn McAfee, 33, of Sacramento, was also arrested on suspicion of an outstanding arrest warrant during the traffic stop with Bishop. And in Illinois, civil liberty groups are pushing back against proposed legislation in Illinois that would allow police to dramatically expand the use of drones to monitor large gatherings and equip those drones with cameras possessing facial recognition technology. The legislation, which amends a previous law limiting drone surveillance, passed the Illinois Senate earlier this month. The changes would allow police to use drones at any large-scale public event of 100 or more people without a warrant. The changes would provide no limitations on the use of drones to monitor political protests, religious gatherings, and other constitutionally protected activities. On Monday, another two amendments were introduced. One put forth by proponents of expansion would limit the use of facial recognition technology at events more than 1,500 people and require police departments to maintain policies on reporting when drones are used. Another by those, including State Rep. Ann Williams, will bump the minimum crowd size for drone monitoring to 10,000, limit the use of facial recognition software, and add requirements that police destroy the footage within a set period of time. Currently, an Illinois statute known as the Freedom from Drone Surveillance Act allows police departments to use drones without a warrant, only in an emergency where swift action is needed to prevent imminent harm to life. The ACLU says the proposed expansion of police powers come in part from a push from Mayor Rahm Emanuel's administration. Their amendment goes way beyond the previous law, and the city has not shown one example of how police don't have the power they need, said Kadeen Bennett, the ACLU's Director of Advocacy and Intergovernmental Affairs. The text of the bill says drone use would be limited to legitimate public safety purposes, including but not limited to evaluating crowd size, density, or movement, assessing public safety vulnerabilities or weaknesses, determining appropriate staffing levels for law enforcement or of other public safety personnel, or identifying possible criminal activity. The changes could also allow cops to use drones to monitor activities like large barbecues or sporting events. A report by the Center on Privacy and Technology at Georgetown Law found that technology can be racially biased. After analyzing the top three facial recognition algorithms, researchers found that all three of the algorithms were 5 to 10% less accurate on African Americans than Caucasians. Furthermore, a similar decline surfaced for females as compared to males and younger subjects as compared to older subjects.